Ladies, gentlemen, pronouns, lend me your ears. Crazy Kid here. I'm back again to comment on another one of the X-Factor Journey for Fourth Impact. This is the six-chair challenge where the competition really starts going into high speed. And they have to fight for their spot on a chair. And at any time, once the chairs are full, they could be eliminated from the chairs. They're not safe until all the contestants are done. So let's just see how our ladies do. I'm going to put it on a different size screen because there's a few things that happen in here that I thought were kind of interesting. So I'm going to be a little bit smaller and you won't be able to see a whole lot of my reaction. But there's a few things that I wanted to show that I thought were pretty interesting.
I'm so nervous.
I'm Eileen.
I'm Irene.
I'm Almira.
I'm Selena.
We're ready for your audition now, so do you want to follow me?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, thank you.
Oh my God.
X Factor, it's very huge for us.
It's the biggest thing ever.
This can change our lives, literally.
And it did change their lives, literally. It's incredible. It's not just their lives that got changed. This show changed the lives of so many people because Fourth Impact's music got more recognition by them being on this show.
Six-year challenge is where the competition really starts.
Hello, ladies.
Hi.
We are going up there fighting for our dream.
We want to make sure that we will sit on that chair.
Yes.
And we will stay on that chair.
Yeah, that's the idea. Stay put. Stay on that chair.
Lovely to see you again.
Thank you.
So obviously we all know your background. You're from the Philippines.
Yes.
Thank you, UK, for welcoming us.
Take a look at how humble these ladies are. They are thanking the audience for welcoming them. They're appreciative of the situation that they're in. They're appreciative of the opportunity that's placed before them. Now it's just up to them to, put on a performance to make sure that they get on that chair and stay there. Oh, look at mommy. So proud.
Are you ready? Let's go.
Take a look at this blonde lady here. She's got the attitude like, who the hell you think you are? What do you think you're going to do? And the one standing beside her is like, you ain't getting our chair. Oh, hell no. Who do you think you are? Yeah, get prepared. You're about to get your mind blown.
Under the city lights, there is a world you know about where rules don't apply, no. And you can't keep a good girl down.
I love the way they started that out at a cappella. That's why you could hear the clarity in their voice.
Hey!
Now that's how you get the crowd on your side. Way to go. Now those harmonies, oh my God, just off the chain.
Everybody just come to life under the spotlight. All the boys wanna fall behind.
What's funny is Irene's got this sweater or jacket tied around her waist, and she's got this bow on her head. Keep an eye on that.
Love it, though.
Okay, girls.
Well, we got a couple more people snapping around.
Let's show them how it's done.
Diamond Light. Okay, at this point here, they're on stage. Fourth Impact is on stage, but right here in the background, who are these people? Did they break the time-space continuum with this song? Like, it's kind of funny. I see Irene and Elmira clearly. Here goes the bit. Here goes the ribbon. The ribbon is down on the floor.
This is insane.
Yeah, that is insane. That is insane. Now that jacket stayed there. She must have really tied a good knot in that jacket, but the ribbon from her hair is over here on the floor somewhere. Yeah, the most unsafe place to sit behind or sit in this audience is right behind Simon, because I think that chair would have been flying. He stood up so fast. There's Proud Mommy.
Really tough, guys.
Oh, it was absolute perfection for me. Literally, your voices, your ad-libs, you all had a moment to show off yourselves vocally. It was like perfection. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, it was like perfection. Like, you can see they're out of breath. Like, Miley's like, I was out of breath the first time I watched this, and I was just sitting here in my chair.
How would you girls like to join the overs category?
Now that's a comment. That's a comment right there. That's just, you know they're going to be sitting on a chair after a comment like that.
I think you are actually amazing. I think you need some help.
Look at the blonde lady here. No more smug look on her face. That's the look of fear on both them. And the interesting thing was, they lost their chair.
Help in terms of the direction of music you should be singing. But I am thrilled that you have chosen this show, this country to compete in. And I think the British public are going to fall in love with you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you very, very much.
You know what? I don't think that you're amazing.
That's... I've said it in the comments section before. I don't like it when the judges do this kind of thing to the contestants. Like, look at the look on Selena's face. She is just devastated by that comment. Like, how do you devastate these people and put them through all this kind of stress? Like, look at the blonde lady over here and the lady with her hands over her mouth. They're just like in shock.
I think that you are phenomenal.
And just to let, just to, make their emotions just explode. Like, you take a person, you make them crash with their emotions, with stress. And then all of a sudden you just, say something to just reverse that. It's about to wonder why there's so many people that have that suffer from bipolar.
You know what? You and I together can create magic. Please go and sit.
Thank you.
Like, I'm glad that they got through. But why did the judges have to put the contestants through that kind of, you know, drama up and down in order to get, you know, like ratings?
Y'all's gonna say.
And coincidentally, the chair that they sat in was the fourth chair. Well, guys, that's my commentary on this episode of the X Factor Journey. I know some people may, put some hating on me for the comments about the judges. But personally, I think it's a horrible thing to do to a person, to make their emotions just bounce up and down like a ball like that. Like to draw their emotions on a yo-yo just for ratings. It's to me, that's a horrible thing to do to a person. But I'm glad that they got through. I'm wholeheartedly glad that they got through. So until the next one, I wish everybody peace, love, and happiness. And I hope everybody enjoyed this episode. And, you know, don't forget to check out some of my other content.